NotAgetOnline.com/LiveWire.
Yeah. As I laid my head down to sleep after an excessive amount of Tylenol PM. It suggests too, but that candy coating. 11 or 12 later, and I'm in La La Land. I have a dream.
Mm-hmm. Time to go to bed.
Good hour. Like 11:45. No, excuse me, 8:45. This happened around 11-ish, though. I remember waking up looking at the clock. Went to bed about 8:45, fell asleep at 9. Chemically induced sleep. I have a dream. I feel a pressure on my chest.
How vivid was the memory of this dream?
Pretty vivid.
Because, you know, sometimes you have them and then they...
They disintegrate in your hands immediately. You're like, oh, I had this great dream. There was a car. Oh, Christ, I can't remember any of it.
But this one you got.
Yeah, because of the simplicity of it.
Okay.
Very simple. Not a lot to remember. As I said, I felt a pressure on my chest at about 11:45.
In your dream?
In my dream.
Or for real?
In my dream / for real.
Oh. Using that like theta state.
Uh-huh. I'm deep.
Mm-hmm.
I feel hot breath. I feel hair. Oh. I feel breath and I feel hair.
Oh.
I crack my eyes open from the sleep, and I am a centimeter away from Josh Spiegel's face. He is completely planking on top of me. He is above the cover, and he is clothed. Oddly enough, wearing a suit. I could just see the sport jacket shoulders, very angular.
And this isn't your dream, because I can't account for about 2 hours of my life last night.
And he's just saying over and over to me.
Okay.
They're there. They're there.
Oh, like right in your face?
Right in my mean. They're
comforting
there.
Comforting you.
They're there. Like he can tell that I'm panicky.
Mm-hmm.
That I don't know what's going to come next.
Shh,
all right.
Shh, shh, shh. And my face is right in your face?
I mean, there. Right there. I can pick up on your... Shh. I can smell the toothpaste on your breath.
Oh, toothpaste.
I can smell the sweat, the hot middle of the night sweat. You're just saying over and over again,
they're there.
They're there. They're there. Over and over again. Now, the reason I think I had said dream is that I woke up moments later, my 27-pound Maine Coon cat, also on my chest, also a centimeter from my face, dead asleep,
also
snoring,
saying, there,
also
there.
Saying, there, there, meow. There, meow, there. There, there, meow, meow, there. There, meow, there. So I know why I felt the pressure. I know why I felt the breath.
Right.
I know why the hair was there. Toothpaste, super weird. I think my cat got into the Colgate.
But why was it Josh?
But why Josh?
Yeah. I can analyze that. And I mean, that's a no-brainer.
Give it to me.
Your cat, you find comfort in your cat.
I do. It's one of the highlights of my day.
You love your cat.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. You unconditionally love your cat. You find comfort in me. I am nothing but comforting to you, and you unconditionally love me. Now, if you could only know what I feel about you.
Can you tell me? Because I don't think you're wrong so far.
Well,
I find a sense of comfort. Mike, you do notice that I never stop in the pit first when I get to work. I come right in here.
Right.
And I sit across from this guy. I see him. I know we're in for a good day. Yeah. I don't see him there in the corner. Full tilt panic mode.
It could also be that whenever Josh is at your house, he poops in a box.
Great point. 38online.com.